scene on the streets of Philadelphia. Swan Fountain in front of City Hall, two of the many landmarks in this great city. It's always been a great sports town, too. Normally this time of year, they're talking Flyers and Sixers, but this week, the brand new CoreStates Center plays host to the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. And more than U.S. titles are on the line, this is where they will name the American Olympic teams. Two spots up for grabs for the men, pairs, and ice dancing competitions, and three for the ladies. Hello and welcome, everyone. I'm Terry Gannon. We begin tonight with the men's short program. It kicks off what will be more than 13 hours of coverage here on ESPN2, over on ESPN, and on ABC Sports, including live coverage of the men's free skate, along with the ladies' short program. That's where you can see Michelle Kwan and Tara Lipinski going head-to-head Thursday night, beginning at 8 o'clock Eastern time on ABC. Well, there's no question that the overwhelming favorite here in the men's event is the 1996 world champion Todd Eldridge, but it hasn't been a great season for him, not one he had hoped for. In warm-ups for the first major competition of the season 2 months ago, this fall on the ice resulted in a separated shoulder. It popped back in, but it was an injury that really affected his skating throughout the season. Todd says now, though, he's ready to go, 100% healthy, ready to go after his fifth national title. Well, the two men joining me right now have not only won this title many times, but also the only gold medal that has eluded Eldridge, Olympic gold, Ryan Boitano and Mr. Dick Button. Dick, you look at Todd Eldridge this season, the season that he has had. What do you think his mindset is now coming into Philadelphia?
Well, look, anytime you consider Todd, you really got to consider his overall character as well as his personality. Remember, he has been through everything. He has won, he has lost, he's been healthy, he's been injured. There's nothing that can happen tonight that should faze him. One of the things you've got to remember is that he's the hardest worker of any skater here. He's also the steadiest competitor. You know, he can go up in the air into a triple axel on an angle and cat-like right himself up and land on a steady edge. And I think maybe that word steady is the best adjective to use in describing him. Remember one thing. I hope and I'm sure that he will do very well right here.
Well, he's the favorite. There's no question about that. But you also have a guy named Scott Davis and Michael Weiss right behind him. Brian, they'd love to take his title away. How do you size up what those three will do tonight?
Well, Terry, I think it's really cut and dry. The key to tonight's short program is really the critical triple combination jump. Scott Davis, Todd Eldridge, and Michael Weiss are all planning the same combination, triple axel, triple toe. Now, this is high risk. And if any of them hopes to be a champion, they need to hit that combination.
The triple jump's always the key to any program, but here in the short program, these are the 8 required elements that you will see. The skaters have to perform these, doesn't matter what form, but they have to try these tonight. The one thing you don't see, a quad. No quadruple jumps in the short program. And we begin with a young man who has been to the Nationals 9 times now, 26-year-old Shepard Clark from Atlanta. Shepard won the Eastern Sectionals to get here. His best finish at the National Championships, a 5th place finish in 95.
This will tell the story with his technical merit. A triple axel, double toe loop. Good triple axel. Tight ending on the double toe loop.
But you know he's been missing those in practices, so it's actually a great thing for him to have hit that, and it should give him confidence for the rest of the program.
He has one of the finest physiques for skating. He's a magnificent looking performer. He's just been unsteady to this point on his triple jumps. This is a triple Lutz. Very good.
This is the best that I've seen him skate in a few years.
Death drop. He presents an imposing picture on the ice. And I think the choice of Bach, the Toccata and Fugue in D minor, are an excellent choice for him.
You know, he has some incredible programs this year that Slavka Kahoot choreographed, and I think they're nice for him.
Remember, on these camel change camel or spin change spins,
There must be a minimum number of turns of revolution on each foot. Not less than 5 revolutions for a total of 10. A double axel. Doesn't he like it? Now don't lose wonderful speed. Final spin. Combination first to camel, sit spin. Lay back. Back spin. You. That was a fine performance.
You've got to be happy with that.
The opening men's short program and a really good one. Well, how nice.
Nice way to start it off, too, here in Philadelphia. He was a 10th place finisher a year ago, but fine performance for Shepherd Clark here in the short program. We'll be back. Back in Philadelphia, 26-year-old Shepherd Clark after one of his best performances in a long time in the short program.
Well, look at this double axel. He gets good height here, good lean triple axel, lands fine, but right there his toe slipped off and it caused problems with the double toe loop.
Here's his triple Lutz. He pole vaults off the right toe. He finishes rotation high enough in the air that he has a great checkout and a wonderful landing.
And his short program is all about not making mistakes. That's what the skaters are out there to do, 8 required elements. But he did have the fans out of their seats here at the CoreStates Center when he left the ice.
You're absolutely right. It was a good performance. Really fine.
5.3.
And now the marks, there'll be two sets of marks. First for required elements.
5.3.
And 5.2s and 5.3s for Shepherd Clark. The reaction of the crowd, I think they expected higher.
5.2.
Remember, it's a comparative marking system. The question will be what the next skaters get.
And the second set will be for presentation. Is there a disadvantage to going first, to being the first man on the ice?
Well, there's both an advantage and a disadvantage. Advantage is you get it over with, and everybody's fresh, and you're right off your practice session. The other problem is, though, that the judges do know that there are other skaters coming, and they have to mark at a very low level in order to get everybody in.
Higher marks for presentation, 5.4, and the rest 5.5 for Shepherd Clark. Good way to start.
5.5. Please welcome Timothy Gable.
Here is a young skater making only his second appearance at the U.S. Senior Nationals. He was a 6th place finisher a year ago. Many expected him to win the World Junior title this year, but he had a hip injury. Here's Timothy Gable, 17 years old from Rolling, Illinois.
And you know, guys, but skating with an injury is so difficult. It's hard enough to concentrate on your jumps and your combinations, but to skate with an injury, you always know it's there.
And there was a lot of speculation as to whether or not he would skate here in Philadelphia. He really wanted to skate, though, and that's why he's out there, but he does have a very bad hip.
First move, a triple flip. And on that one, you could see clearly that the toe pick just slipped off the ice. That's unusual for him. But this combination is what he needs right here. Triple axel, triple toe loop.
What a save on that. That was a great save.
Very bad form, but wonderful jump. Circular footwork. He has wonderful athletic ability. Not a great sense of style or theatrical quality, but his jumping ability is first rate. Thank you.
actually had some trouble with that double axel coming out of the knee slide because it's a very hard entrance. In the warm-up, he was having trouble with that.
Good spin. Be nice if his back was straighter, but the centering is good.
Timothy Gable, only 17 years old. His first trip last year in Nashville to the U.S. Senior Nationals. Come back with his scores when we return to the CoreStates Center in Philadelphia. And when we come back, Michael Weiss takes the ice. He's one of the top contenders here. Timothy Gable looking up and awaiting his scores after his short program. Gutsy performance because he comes in here with an injury.
Here you see his footwork into triple flip. He pole vaults off the right toe, but his position is a little bit back right here, and so he has to flop on out of that.
And on the triple axel, look at how low he is bent over going into that. But nice revolution and a very, very tough landing. But he did do a triple toe loop afterwards.
You see the smile after that, too. A lot of nervous energy, no doubt, with young skaters like Timothy, only 17 years old. Coming here in front of a crowd like this, Carol Heiss-Jenkins and Glenn Watts, his coaches, the required element marks 4.8 up to 5.1.
I think those marks are considerably lower than Shepard Clark's, which makes an interesting commentary, doesn't it?
5.3. Now the second set of marks for presentation, and those are higher for Gable, 5.0 to 5.4.
But still lower than Clark's.
5.3 and 5.3.
Hey, good job.
Here is one of the few skaters with a chance to challenge Todd Eldridge and to make the Olympic team. Michael Weiss, 21 years old, the silver medalist a year ago. There's his dad, Greg, on the right, his sister, Jenna, athletes themselves. Over the summer, he married his choreographer. There's Lisa. Michael Weiss. Cheering him on close to the surface of the ice.
Nice looking family. And watch how he keeps the character of this dance throughout the entire program. That's unusual and very interesting. The music Flamenco by guitar soloist Jesse Cook.
And I really feel artistically Michael's made a lot of improvements over the last year. And you can see it in his programs that he's trying to reach in different directions.
We'll be seeing many of them this week from an outside edge. Beautiful jump.
Probably the easiest jump that Michael does. It's so easy for him.
That's why it's the Lutz that he does as a triple, as a quadruple jump.
He'll try that quad Lutz in the free skate. He says he's planning it. That'll be Thursday night on ABC.
Now on this coming up triple axel, note the fact that he does not step up.
Wow, he just hung on to that one.
Wow.
A little far forward on the triple axel, but he still pulled off a triple toe afterwards.
I think the basic problem was that he doesn't step up into that triple axel and therefore doesn't get quite enough height. Trouble on that back spin. This is one of the required elements, a circular step. Maintaining the character of the dance. Now again, watch this forward edge jump. Nice double axel, but again, not very much step up into that.
Mm-hmm.
move this desk drop. Good height on it. Good height. And a good back sit spin.
Well, he's got to be happy with that.
I think so.
Nice. Oh, Mike! Yes!
Well, his dad's happy about it, that's for sure.
You think?
And they're not the only ones out of their seats here at the CoreStates Center. So the audience certainly liking the short program of Michael Weiss.
It was very, very good overall program.
We'll check his scores, no doubt high scores when we come back. And also Todd Eldridge will take the ice next.
International Figure Skating, the premier magazine for the sport and art of figure skating. From the triumphs of Olympic champions to the efforts of Olympic hopefuls, International Figure Skating brings you on the ice and behind the scenes. Call 1-800-627-4052 to receive 8 issues for just $19. That's more than 50% off our newsstand price. Call 1-800-627-4052 to stay on top of the world of international figure skating.
Michael Weiss, along with Audrey Weisiger, awaiting his scores after his short program.
Maybe people will hear about
the judges' marks for Michael Weiss for required
and
elements.
Look at the way he steps up into that triple axel, hardly stepping up at all. That causes difficulty in getting height and distance, and results in this little trouble that he had at the end of that two-jump combination.
And very little trouble. So much has been made of his quad lutz that he'll try in the men's free skate. He's just trying to hang on here in the short program. Nearly perfect, not quite. The required element marks 5.4 up to 5.8.
5.7.
And the best that we have seen so far. And now the second set of marks for presentation again. The highest that we have seen, 5.6 up to 5.8. The range for Michael Weiss, one of the key contenders here in Philadelphia this year.
That overall character, really quiet. Good.
Four-time U.S. champion Todd Eldridge believes that things happen for a reason. A dislocated shoulder earlier this season slowed his progress this year, but his target is still 4 weeks away.
Well, I think, actually, I think I'm right where I want to be at this point. You know, I started the season off kind of indifferent, I guess you could say. And then since La Ligue, things have been going well, and you know, the Champions Series final went really well for me as far as my skating was concerned. So I think I started to build a little momentum there, and you know, we'll just kind of keep it going, and you know, hopefully at the end of February, that'll be the peak of our momentum.
He is skating to walk on the wild side from the casino side track. He represents the DeJoint Skating Club in Bloomfield Hills, Michigan. Ladies and gentlemen, Todd Eldridge.
Well, after watching Todd Eldridge throughout his career, you have to believe at this point he knows how to get ready for any competition and knows when to peak. Up and down career, but a champion.
This guy is a great competitor, but he still knows that Michael Weiss hit everything right before him. He knows that, and everybody wants this guy's position. They want to be the champion, so this is a tough place to skate.
Walk on the Wild Side from the movie Casino. His first move, the triple axel two jump combination. Triple axel, triple toe loop. Now that was superb.
That is probably one of Todd's most confident elements in this program.
And look at the centering he gets on this spin. Now, very few of the men or anybody in skating really gets good centers. He's one of them. That's really terrific spinning.
You know, that's what makes this program so great. It's a great package. It's great spinning, great jumping. He looks okay. He looks wonderful with the choreography. It's good.
Thank you. his footwork into his triple Lutz jump.
He's had trouble with that jump in all the practices, and I think that he'll be happy with that.
Kind of a microcosm of his career, though, fighting to hang on to it at the end.
Now look at this combination spin. First the camel, sit spin. Again, look at the centering that he gets there. That means spinning in one spot. Cannonball position, and look at this for a backspin. Now that's a good backspin.
Nobody does it better.
Nope. One more jump, this double axel. Remember when he blew the double axel after doing all the triple jumps? Lost concentration.
Beautiful.
Not this time. Good for him. As steady as they come.
There's John and Ruth Eldridge, his mom and his uncle is there as well. The folks in South Chatham, Massachusetts have been a big part of all of his accomplishments through the years. The entire town.
It's nice to see the whole families of all these skaters coming to the fore here and supporting them.
And what a sense of accomplishment skating after the great performance of Michael Weiss. He's got to feel great.
And this is a guy who almost gave up skating altogether back in the early 90s, but going after his fifth U.S. title would be one more than Scott Hamilton and Brian Boitano. Dick Button off in the stratosphere somewhere with seven.
Now, look at this triple axel. Watch him just take up straight, tight legs, beautiful turns, beautiful landing, stepping up right into a triple toe loop. You can't do better or more, be more secure than that is.
Now here's his triple Lutz. Well, I want to see on the landing if he two-foots this. It looked like to me like he might have two-footed. He's a little setting up. Oh, no, he didn't. He did not two-foot it. He was a little far forward on the landing, but there's no deduction on that.
There's Richard Callahan, who also coaches Tara Lipinski, of course.
5.8.
Michael Weiss 5.8. With the highest scores yet, but here are the required element 5.8. Marks, all 5.8.
5.8.
The best so far.
5.8. And
well, after he won the competition in which he separated his shoulder, he and came in fourth and third at the other major competitions this year. Really disappointed with those, but as you heard him say, he feels like he's in top shape right now. On the presentation marks 5.8 and 5.9 for Todd Eldridge. Perhaps on his way to his fifth national title. In the lead right now. We'll be back.
Presents the Los Angeles Figure Skating Club in Burbank, California. He's skating to the music Dark Eyes. Please welcome Michael Chack.
Welcome back to Philadelphia. The State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships continue with 26-year-old Michael Chack competing at his sixth U.S. National.
The music, Dark Eyes. His first move, the two jump combination. I'm sorry, it was just the double axel that he was.
Actually, I think maybe Dick, he did have the triple axel plan there, but he may have popped it into a double. So we have to see now what he's going to do with where we think the double axel is. He's going to have to do a combination somewhere in this program, and that's what we have to see. Here it comes right here. This is where he's going to do it.
And this was, there it is. Oh, and that would do it was to have been a footwork into a triple Lutz jump. You know, one of the problems of changing things as you're doing the program, it leaves you with an insecurity and a lack of practice and understanding
of where
you're
not used to it. You're just not used to it.
Nope.
Now he's got to do that triple Lutz somewhere. He's got to put that in. He's reconstructing the program as we're watching.
Oh.
Is there anything you can do during practice or that either one of you ever did to try to prepare for situations like this?
Yes, don't make mistakes.
There's his triplets. See, it's thrown him all off, having to reconstruct the program that threw his triplets up. I haven't seen him miss that triplets in any of the practices. And what's happening during the whole program, you're constantly re-choreographing the program. Where am I going to do this? Well, you're not concentrating on what you're doing at the moment. That's got to be disappointing for him. He's had such good practices, and I really thought he was going to skate well tonight.
But, you know, the problem is that there are mandatory deductions here, and that is just going to kill his marks.
Not the night that Michael Check of Los Angeles had hoped for. He was a bronze medalist at this event back in 93. We'll have his marks in a moment. Welcome back to the CoreStates Center in Philadelphia. 26-year-old Michael Check shaking his head. Didn't like what happened in this short program. Number of mistakes. And he's had success at this event before. He captured the bronze medal back in 1993.
Yeah, those marks reflect an 8/10 deduction, 4/10 for each of those mistakes that he made.
And his marks for presentation.
Well, it's a very discouraging point for him.
4.7.
You know, this is not an easy sport.
No, it's not.
5.0.
And the marks for presentation, 4.7 up to 5.4 for Michael Check.
5.2.
It was in 1986 that Debbie Thomas became the first African-American to capture gold at the World Championships. Last month, Derek Delmore became the first to claim the World Junior title. For him, it is clearly a point of pride.
Yes, definitely. It was pointed out to me afterwards. I didn't even think about it beforehand. And I guess maybe if I had thought about it going in, it would have been this, you know, major pressure thing. Oh, I could be the first African American to win this title. But I didn't really, like I said, think about it at all. And I'm really honored to be the first African American to win the Junior World Championship title.
Fresh off of his win at the World Junior Championships, here he is at the Senior Nationals in Philadelphia. Finished 11th a year ago, 19-year-old Derek Delmore.
He clearly has a distinctive sense of style throughout this entire program.
He has improved so much in 1 year in every way. His skating in between the jumps and the jumps themselves are so much more consistent than they were.
The positions continue the sense of the character of the music and the dance. Even here, the way he's stretching, leading into this triple lutz. This combination coming up, a triple axel with a show loop.
It's a little bit under rotated, a little slow going into it as well.
Did you notice how he dipped forward going onto that forward outside edge? That'll be a mandatory deduction.
I think they're going to have to take 3/10 off for that.
One of the few men that can is limber enough to do that.
these moves. Very characteristic of the performance. Very nice. The musical skater. Very nice. You know, that's a complete program. Beautifully put together, well-rounded, finished, good character. Nice performance.
19 years old and a sophomore at Stanford, Derek Delmore. When we come back, his scores, and Dan Hollander takes the ice.
0.7. 4.4.
Back at the State Farm 4. U.S. 9. Championships, Derek Delmore 5. With his coach, 0. Shirley Hughes, and the required 8. Element marks 4.4 up to 5.1.
Quite a difference in those marks, you know, from 4.4 to 5.0.
5.4.
But I think these marks reflect the fact that he had a character, that he had a good sense of style, and that he had good personality in his performance.
5.2 and 5.3. Please welcome Dan Hollander.
And here now is Dan Hollander. The last two seasons, the bronze medalist. Twice he's gone to the World Championships. He'd love to earn a spot on the Olympic team, and he has a chance of doing that.
And Dan's trying the hardest combination of the competition, triple axel, triple loop. But he hasn't been hitting a high percentage of these in practice, and he missed both attempts on the 6-minute warm-up before. So he has got to concentrate going into this.
Remember one thing about his skating. He's got flair, he's musical, and he's a very interesting skater. Nevertheless, the elements are what count in this program. The first, the triple Lutz.
Hung on to that one.
But here comes the key, the triple axel, triple loop combination. Triple axel, double loop, and he fell out of that. Serpentine footwork. And look at the character to these steps. A straight line step right down the length of the rink, and look at the quickness, the sense of humor, and the musicality of this. First break. Double axel.
He had to shoot himself for that.
Well, how many times has that happened to how many important skaters where they just blow it on a jump that they can do in their sleep? That destroys his chances for any title in this competition. That's going to knock him right off the block. What a shame.
Well, you can see it on his face, too. He knows that, and it came at the end of his program.
Well, there must have been something that he just lost his sense of concentration. It happened to Todd Eldridge, but only once.
So Dan Hollander, with his short program, mistakes at the end of it. Tara Lipinski, you'll see her in the ladies short program on ABC tomorrow night. She's watching.
And eating.
Tara trains in Detroit along with Todd Eldridge and Dan Hollander, and Dan and his coach Mitch Moyer talking about the mistake that he made at the end of his program.
Well, this combination, first the triple axel. Now watch as he steps up and turns and completes it right there, but there it's sort of as though he changed his mind, and instead of being able to get a good triple loop, he lost it and did a weak double.
Hope she didn't have to buy a ticket to get in here.
How do you like that long hair? Do you think she's changed a lot over the last year?
Yep. It is obvious.
Well, here he is stepping on his left foot forward, and he's supposed to do 2.5 rotations, and he pops it into a single.
What a pity.
Yeah.
Well, no matter how many times you've done it in past competitions or in practice, it's whether or not you can pull it off when you step out there
tonight. It's more frustrating to pop something because you don't even attempt it.
And
what happened to him? Why do you think that happened? Well, I just don't understand that kind of thinking. I mean, what makes you lose concentration?
It didn't look like he was really losing concentration. It looked like it was something that just happened. He doesn't seem like the kind of skater that's thoughtless enough to not concentrate.
No, thoughtlessness had nothing to do with it.
And the required element marks, Dick, 4.7 up to 5.1 reflect that.
They're bound to be at that level. The question is, what makes you check, hold back, stop, whatever it is that makes you do that at this particular crucial moment?
5.2. The presentation marks much higher, though, in a wide range, 5.2 all the way up to a 5.7 for Dan Hollander, but not the program or the marks that he wished for. So Todd Eldridge leads Michael Weiss and Shepard Clark here in the men's short program. And on the ice right now, 24-year-old John Baldwin Jr., his fifth trip to the Senior Nationals. And he finished 13th a year ago.
And his dad told me last night, his dad coaches him, and he said this triple axel has become a lot more consistent this year, and he hardly ever misses him in practice.
His father, one of his coaches.
Here it is.
Hung on to that one.
He did it.
Forward,
did it.
Yeah.
Again, he was a skater that did not step up into that jump. I always wonder how they can get the revolution and the height necessary to do the revolution without that step up. You, Brian, step up better than anybody.
Thanks, Dick.
It was a lie. There.
He's already got to be happy with this. He had a real tough skate last year at the national championships, I think, missing a lot of things and actually stopping because he knocked himself out a little bit.
These circular step, that means steps in a circular pattern, are one of the required elements. Two-step combination sequences, but of a different nature, either straight line, circular, or in the serpentine form, are required as two of the eight elements. Again, very nice positions through that combination. And this back cross position, very interesting. One final jump left, this double axel. Remember, that is truly a difficult jump because of the forward edge. That forward edge can go left, right, or straight ahead at the last possible notice and can leave you flat on your back without any warning. He missed the music on the end of that, it seems. The rest of the program kind of with it.
Much more pleased this year, though, after the short program than he was a year ago.
Oh, he's got to be.
Yeah, 13th last year in Nashville.
Some good moves there.
John Baldwin Jr. And coming up next, two-time U.S. champion Scott Davis takes the ice. Back in Philadelphia, Terry Gannon, Brian Boitano, Dick Button, and Leslie Visscher at the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. John Baldwin Jr., along with his coaches, who are also his parents, Donna and John Sr. The required element marks 4.8 up to 5.2.
And not bad, you know.
And
not bad at all.
Presentation. 5.3.
13th a year ago in Nashville. He looked up at the scoreboard. That's what it said. He said, it's got to be better than that after that performance, and I think it probably will. The presentation marks 4.9 up to 5.4.
Well, it's nice to see him skate well. It's always encouraging.
And in sixth place in terms of those that have skated. 4 years ago, Scott Davis defeated Brian Boitano to win his second consecutive national title, the biggest win of his career. He went on to finish eighth at the Olympics, and his future looked unlimited. But Davis was unable to maintain that level of success. Now he pursues a return trip to the Olympics, older and wiser.
Well, I think I've grown as a skater and grown up as a person. You know, like I said before, it's kind of happened really fast for me, those 2 years, 93 and 94. And I didn't really know what went along with being national champion and being number one. So it kind of distracted me for a while. But now, you know, I've seen both sides of the coin and know more who I am and how to handle myself and the nerves and that aspect much better.
Handling nerves and meeting expectations, a big part of what Scott Davis has tried to tackle the last few years. When he finished second recently at a major competition, he said it was the best performance since his win at the Nationals in 94.
The music. Buddy Guy and Benny Goodman. And this is two jump combination. First, the triple axel. Triple loop, double loop. Very nice. Really well done. Why he puts it way up there in the corner of the rink, I'll never know. But I guess almost all the skaters move everything right to the edge of the barrier. Straight line into a triple lutz. Here it is. Ah, and he popped that. No. What? Well, I'll tell you something. That does a number on his mark.
The 4/10 deduction right there.
But look at what a good spinner he is. He spins like a top. He and Todd Eldridge are wonderful spinners. They have great centers. Look at the speed he gets here. Flying death drop. One of the things he has going for him is he's very musical. Double axel. Serpentine footwork. Look at the pattern that he's skating on the ice. These are good steps. Combination spin, first a camel, good speed, good center, wonderful speed, and a great back cross position.
You know, he's just got to be disappointed. He hit the hard thing, and he hit something that should be relatively easy for him to do.
But that's always what happens. It even happened with Todd Eldridge at the World Championship last year when he lost on the double axel at the end of the program.
Two spots available on the U.S. Olympic team. Todd Eldridge will get one of them. Michael Weiss, maybe, or Scott Davis, the other. We'll be back with his marks. And we are just getting started here in Philadelphia. There is more of the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships tomorrow at 8 p.m. on ABC Sports with the ladies' short program and live coverage of the men's free skate. Then, Friday at 9 p.m. on ESPN, you'll see more of the ladies' short program and the original dance. Welcome back to Philadelphia. The two-time U.S. champion Scott Davis came in very confident, but this is an unforgiving sport, isn't it?
To get great height on this triple lutz, you need to reach this right leg far back. He doesn't reach back quite enough, and he ends up popping it into a single.
And the clear reaction of his coach, Galina Zmijevskaya, is a beauty. Oh, look at that. How discouraging.
And Nina Petrenko, the wife of Victor Petrenko. Galina, her mother. Scott Davis, when he came in, he was coming off a second-place finish at the NHK competition, and he said it may have been his best performance that he can remember.
But even in that championship, he did not skate well in the short program. He had to pull himself up from fifth place.
Required element marks 4.9 to 5.4, the range, Dick. That's a wide range.
Yes, and the range is pretty high. You know, I mean, the level is pretty high for that major miss. That he'll get good marks here.
There you see the reflection of the 4/10 deduction, 5.2, 5.6 for the first judge.
But the presentation marks are higher, 5.5 up to 5.8. Scott Davis, that puts him in third place, right behind Michael Weiss.
And knocking out Shepard Clark.
It's not finished.
And here is the final skater of the men's short program, 22-year-old Trifon Savanovits of Los Angeles. He was a silver medalist from the U.S. Junior Nationals back in 95. Competed at seniors in 96, where he finished seventh.
Not the easiest place to skate in, knowing that you're the last one out of the entire evening.
Well, maybe he'll blast off using the music, the Flying Circus from the Rocketeer. By John Horner.
Nice
is
triple
a nice
flip.
Choice.
It was, yeah, he and did blast off into that triple flip.
You bet. By the way, he's an interesting character. He has bent over shoulders, some of the worst posture in skating, and he presents some of the nicest and most exciting moves and positions. Look at that. Did you see the bend over
pretty
way
nice.
He went into that, and yet the jump was fine?
I think he has chutzpah.
So, you even know what Utspa means? And there's one thing about his skating you'll notice is that the audience likes it. He seems to be having fun with it.
Yeah, he does. Definitely seems to be having fun.
He has good energy. Good excitement, sometimes terrible posture. And an almost carefree kind of flailing of some of the moves. Look at his position is nice, the back overly round shoulder, unnecessarily so. I'm a must say, I think the audience genuinely likes the freshness, the energy, and the excitement that he gives, and the chutzpah, as you said, Brian, as he brings to this program.
We'll try to check our posture, and we'll check his scores. 22-year-old Trifon Zivanovic, his marks when we come back to Philadelphia. Trifon Zivanovic and his coach, Gary Visconti, excited after what was really an exciting short program.
Here's his triple axel double toe. You can see that his air position isn't great. He has a little air in between his legs, but he still pulls it out and does a clean triple axel double toe combination.
I couldn't get over how far he leans over going into that before he takes off. And he's looking away from where he's going.
He does, yes.
But a positive short program, no doubt about it, for this young man who has only competed at the senior national level twice.
And that's his coach, Gary Visconti, a former American champion skater.
Some friends there.
Trifon, a seventh place finish in 96. Last year had to withdraw in Nashville because of a sprained knee.
Now, you'd be interested to note that the choreographer of his short program was both Gary Visconti and Trifon. And I think that tells something about the input that he likes to have in his skating.
He's an independent guy.
5.3.
As they say, a free spirit.
5.1.
And Nicole Bobek of the Vail Skating World.
And there are the marks for required elements. 5.1 up to 5.4.
Those are really quite good marks.
And 5.2.
And the second set score presentation. Remember, this short program worth one-third of the overall score.
5.0.
And a little bit lower for presentation, 5.0 up to 5.4.
Now, one of the interesting things is that Trifon Zivanovic came in fifth at the end of this, just being beaten out by Shepard Clark, who was the first skater. What does that tell you?
It tells you you can't take the ice first and still finish up well. Well, no surprise, Todd Eldridge in the lead, but that second Olympic spot up for grabs. Michael Weiss and Scott Davis in great shape. Shepard Clark as well, and a gutsy performance by an injured Timothy Gable. Leslie Visser is standing by with the two men on top of the leaderboard right now. Leslie?
Terry, these are two men who are halfway home. Todd, first to you. You got a standing ovation for your short program. What went well for you tonight?
Everything went pretty well. I went out, I felt really good, the ice felt good, and good to get a good clean short under my belt, and hopefully have a good long.
Todd, you have to know that in the Olympics at least three of your competitors will be attempting a quad. Why don't you do one here and get one under your belt?
Well, that's actually a decision that's still out, so most likely we probably won't, but we still haven't decided yet.
Well, we will wait and see. Congratulations so far. Michael, to you, our defending silver medalist, what did you want to showcase tonight?
Basically, I just wanted to get off to a good start, come in, skate a clean short program, and get a good feeling for the ice and the audience and the crowd, and things went well for me tonight.
Well, now, you remember a year ago, you thought you landed a quad. Many people thought you landed a quad. How do you feel about this year, and what kind of quad will you attempt?
I feel great. After Worlds last year, I really felt like the quad lutz was something that I wanted to go after. It was a more difficult quad, and it's something that nobody else in the world has landed. So it was something that I really wanted to personally go after myself, and I've really worked hard all this year, and it's going to be in the program for the long program.
Well, America will be watching. Congratulations so far to both of you. Back to you, Terry.
All right, Leslie, and you have to be happy for Scott Davis, the two-time U.S. champion. He indeed may be back. Michael Weiss could be on his way to the Olympics. He has the quad jump plan for the finals. And Todd Eldridge going after his fifth U.S. title. The finals on ABC tomorrow night, the men's free skate. But when we continue from Philadelphia, we'll see if Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon can defend a title they took away from Jenny Mino and Todd Sand. The pair's short program comes up next. The city of Philadelphia still shining in the glow of the holiday season. On an unseasonably warm night in January, we are inside the CoreStates Center as the best figure skaters in America have come to compete for the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. And hello again, everyone. I'm Terry again, and our coverage continues here on ESPN2 with the pair's short program. Tonight, we'll find out how they'll stand heading into the free skate, which you can see along with live coverage of the ladies' free skate. That's where Michelle Kwan and Tara Lipinski will go head-to-head for the gold medal here in Philadelphia Saturday night beginning at 8 o'clock Eastern time over on ABC Sports. Meanwhile, there are two spots on the Olympic teams up for grabs here in the pairs competitions, and two favorites coming into this. Jenny Mino and Todd Sand, along with the defending champions Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon. And we bring in the two-time Olympic champion, Mr. Dick Button. Dick, Ina and Dungeon have not had a good season. They've struggled this year so far competing. What are your thoughts on what they bring to the ice coming in?
Well, you know, Kyoko Ina has been recognized for a very long time as a really gorgeous athlete with great line. And Jason has some of the best partnering ability around. But as they say themselves, they've been second for a long time. Now, why is that? It's because they haven't fulfilled one half of their potential. They won the national championship last year as much because Mino and Sand fell flat as a pancake as because they skated well. They haven't seemed to absorb the contributions that the great pair skaters like the Protopopovs, Rodnin Zaitsev, and Gordiev and Grinkov have made. They just seem to set their sights too low. But if they're ever going to do it, this is the time. This is their Olympics coming up. This is their year.
Last year was their national championships. They won it. The three previous years, though, Jenny Mino and Todd Sand had won. And as we welcome in Olympic champion Peggy Fleming, you look back on last season for Jenny and Todd, though. They don't look back on it fondly. How might that affect them coming in here?
Well, Terry, it was a season of injury and disappointment, but what stung the most for Jenny and Todd was the loss of their national title. And the uncharacteristic mistakes they made in both the short and the long programs, I think, made that loss even more painful. Todd has said they were overconfident last year, but that they did learn an important lesson. But this year, they want that title back, but they are remembering to savor every moment. And I think they are definitely capable of winning this championship.
What matters is what they do on the ice here in Philadelphia. The short program coming up, those are the eight required elements. Some of the skaters think this is the most agonizing time of the whole week. You make one mistake, and it damages your chances. And the first pair to take the ice, 16-year-old Shelby Lyons and 27-year-old Brian Wells. They finished fourth at last year's U.S. Nationals, barely missing the podium and a trip to the World Championships.
The music, El Condor Pasa by Los Incos.
Element in the program is the side-by-side triple sow cows. Oh, he opened out on that takeoff.
Now just remember one thing, that this part of the competition is one by which you can lose the championship, but you can't win it. That means if you make a mistake on the compulsory moves like he just did.
And that was a pretty major move.
Yes,
triple jumps.
You got it.
If that's the name of the game in the pair skating these days.
If you make a move like miss like that, you can lose your chances at a title win. If you win this event, you still have to win the freestyle.
And in the free skate, remember, if you're in the top three and you win that portion of the competition, you are the winner. The short program worth one-third of the overall score.
Is that he pressed her into the air with both hands. That is called a press hand-to-hand lift. And this, a back outside edge death spiral. This program so far really lacking in fire and excitement.
Yes, I agree.
Thank you. like so many of the skaters I've seen in the last few days of this championship, they missed the end of their music. I don't quite understand why they haven't trained or have not set up their program so that they can make that ending.
Yes, when you do a program like that, it is kind of a disappointment to them.
The opening performance in the pair short program, Shelby Lyons and Brian Wells. They're the three-time U.S. champions, Jenny Mino and Todd Senn. They want their title back. They'll take the ice when we come back. The CoreStates Center in Philadelphia, Shelby Lyons and Brian Wells following their short program.
And here's a look at that major mistake that they had in the side-by-side triple Saukaus. He just opened out on his takeoff, and she completed the triple very nicely. A more difficult triple than a triple toe, which you'll see some of the other skaters do.
But it didn't do them any good.
It certainly did. 5.0.
So the first set of marks for required elements, 5.0 to 5.2. The second set will be for presentation. Remember, this short program worth one-third of the overall score. And there's Jenny Mino, along with Todd Sand, her husband, on the ice warming up. Three straight titles for them until last year. A disappointing season for them. And now the second set of marks for Lyons and Wells. All five fives. Well, that's consistency at least.
Yeah, well, it was an okay performance. Not their best.
5.5 and 5.5. This year they took a different approach. They stayed home and trained. They only competed one time in a major event. They came in second at that event. Jenny Mino and Todd Sand hoping to get their title back and go back to the Olympic Games.
They exude understated elegance and classical line, but first they have to get through these side-by-side triple toe loops.
I think they're going to do side-by-side triple toe loops, which is a little easier for them. Remember, and here they are.
Them.
Good show. Doesn't matter what it was okay. Split, double twist. First the split, the twist and land. And if he doesn't set her down on a very clean edge, that can be disaster for both of them.
Watch how easy their skating is. They never rush any of their moves.
Air combination. She has a wonderful back position throughout all of her skating. Side-by-side, camel, sit, spin, combinations. This spiral sequence, one of the required elements, but it shows their line, the extension, the unison of this pair. The legs are together, the bodies are together. That's good.
Very unusual choice of music, I think. It's a bit too traditional, though, for the ending of a program.
Now look at this overhead, and watch the exit. Right there.
Paid off.
You know, it's an It's really interesting to see how this worked out. It was easy. It was a simple program. It wasn't complicated. It was very old-fashioned, but very nice.
And you saw Janice and John Mino. Jenny's parents, she was born in nearby New Jersey. She's got a large contingent here in the CoreStates Center. And not only them, but the entire house up for a standing ovation. We'll be back with the no doubt very high marks of Jenny Mino and Todd Sand when we return in a moment. Back in Philadelphia, Jenny Mino, Todd Sand, and their coach, John Nix, after a dazzling short program. They've gone through so much, but they were nearly perfect tonight.
And here's what they've been working on a lot this past year, side-by-side triple toe loops, which they executed very well. And they've been consistent in all the practices all week.
But this is wonderful. Look at her back. The position, the position of the legs was wonderful. I'll get it out yet. They drop out, the exit was just perfect for her, too.
You gonna be okay?
Sorry, I goofed on that.
Well, no one really knew what to expect from these two. They only competed one time this year. They came in second at what's called the NHK competition in Japan. They're the required element marks, 5.6 up to 5.8.
Well, you see, they were taking a very careful approach to it. It was very easy, easily put together program, beautifully put together by Leanne Miller, and very traditional. And they did what they did beautifully.
Well, they can't ask for much more than what they did on the ice. The presentation marks, and that'll be tough to beat. 5.8 to 10. 5.8. So Mino and Sand set a very high standard, but here is one of the young teams that won the junior national title in 95 and then the world junior title last season. The brother-sister team of Danielle and Steve Hartzell.
They're skating to the music, Lord of the Dance, choreographed by Alan Schramm.
That particular choice of music is rather hard to fulfill. Irish clog dancing is really an up and down movement. Skating is a long movement. It's a very difficult choice. Double twist, good height. But once again, the name of the game comes up right here, side by side, triple toe loops.
He was leaning on that takeoff before he even put his toe in.
Disaster. That's a mandatory markdown of enough points to drop them already into second or third place.
They're off unison on that exit of the spin.
And remember, only two teams go to the Olympic Games. You have to imagine that's Mino and Sand, Ina and Dungeon, but that third spot on the podium, at least, the bronze medal, wide open. Many felt this team had a chance. And they still.
It was a nice death spiral, but the toe on the free leg was pointed straight up in the air. It should be turned out so it has a more long line.
Oh, goodness. I'm so glad somebody else is talking about pointed toes besides me.
Have you mentioned that before?
Well, we'll see some good ones later on.
Their final move, a pair spin combination. Unfinished at the end, but they're very strong skaters. They certainly give the impression of security on the ice. Remember, they're young and unfinished. Very nice.
Junior world title holders last year, Danielle and Steve Hartzell, back with their marks, and we return. Back at the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships, Danielle and Steve Hartzell. And their required element marks, 4.7 up to 5.2.
But I think the low marks were not only because he missed that triple jump, but also because they were a little uneven. They weren't really refined and developed yet. But they're very young, and they're very strong, and they have a great deal of potential.
She's 17 years old. Steve turned 20 yesterday. Wanted a better birthday present than that, though. Presentation marks 5.0 to 5.4. After finishing second three straight years, last season, Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon took the title away from Mino and Sand. They feel that each experience is a source of motivation.
Well, you know, I mean, as far as Jamie and Todd trying to win back their title, I understand how they would feel because, I mean, we've been in second for so many years. We know what it feels like. So, actually, I think that'll help us because we know that someone's trying to push us from behind and we want to strive to be even better. To win nationals is icing on the cake. We want to be able to go out and perform and have everyone say, wow, that is Olympic quality skating.
Welcome now, Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon.
Well, they certainly know both sides of the equation. And after winning the title last season, this year has been a disappointing one. Second at Skate America, then sixth at Trophy La Ligue. Trying to win the title again, Kyoko Ina and Jason Dungeon.
The music, Lion. From the Best of Kodo.
And they have chosen to go back to last year's short program, and I think it's probably the best program they've ever done. The music and the choreography. Choreography done by Leanne Miller.
Now that's good unison.
Watch the height on this split double twist.
Oh, that's a beauty.
Spectacular.
That's the best in the business.
I think this choice of music and the choreography really suits them very well. And all this pounding drum beat, I think, emphasizes the power that this team has in their skating.
By side, triple toe loops.
Nicely
good,
done.
Good.
Great unison on the landing. Good position.
We should point out part of the reason for their disappointing season, injury and illness. Jason dislocated his thumb in their first competition, then had food poisoning in the second one.
Well, this is an infinitely better program and better performance than they've had in a long time. I guess when you find skaters that are very talented, you demand more of them than you do of lesser skaters who don't have the physical talent.
And there again is that toe pointing straight up. If she would just turn it over, it would look like a nice long line.
Now this is the hand-to-hand loop lift next. The man must pick her up with a hand-to-hand position, which then, in this case, turns into a turning lift and a flip over back down and out. Very difficult, very nice.
Very unusual ending.
Yes, nice that it didn't stop.
Yeah.
This was a very successful program. Leanne Miller did a nice job choreographing it.
Well, they took the ice knowing that Mino and Sand had skated very well and are in the lead, and knowing that they're going to need very high marks from the judges here in the short program to keep pace, and they may have done that. You could tell they were very pleased with what just took place.
This program had a lot of life, and I think the audience was really into it.
That's a smile we haven't seen this season so far.
And this is a look at the height that she gets in this split double twist. Wow, it is just spectacular. And now watch this death spiral. This is a very good death spiral, but it would be even better if she would turn the toe out. It would look like a longer line. See how it's pointed up to the ceiling.
See, that's
that would improve this move tremendously.
That's a move that the Protopopovs would never have permitted, that kind of position.
Their coach, Peter Burrows, and should they move on to the Olympics, which we expect them to do, they may have an advantage. Kyoko was born in Japan, and the Japanese public has kind of adopted them as their favorite pairs team.
There they are with their coaches, Peter Burrows on the right, Mary Lynn Gelderman on the left.
And the first set of marks for required elements, 5.7s. There's 1.57 up there, the rest 5.8s. Those are very high.
And those are very good because it was a very solid performance.
And 5.8.
Remember, Mino and Sand in the lead, Lions and Wells in second place right now.
5.6. 5.8.
March for presentation. The crowd doesn't like these. They expected higher, Dick.
Well, their style, you know, I keep saying that they should stretch more, that they should pull more, and I think that would have made the difference of that extra point.
But those scores are good enough to put them in first place ahead of Mino and Sand right now.
Tiffany Stiegler and Johnny Stiegler.
And here's a young pair that you better watch out for at the 2002 Olympic Games. They won a U.S. novice title in 95, a U.S. junior title in 97. Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler.
And they're coached by Irina Rodnina, the great Russian pair skater.
And I think this pair has enormous potential. And you can really see the influence that Rodnina has had on them.
As well as Peter Opegaard, who taught them for many years prior to this.
Side by side, double axles. Nicely done. They fell on that in the warm-up.
He did, and not once, but many times. And this a split double twist.
And you may recognize the name, their older sister, Stephanie Stiegler, won a bronze medal in this event last year with John Zimmerman. Stephanie recovering from shoulder surgery, and the pair has broken up, but she can't wait to get back on the ice and compete again.
Side by side spins.
A little out of sync. This is where I see the influence of Irina. Watch how they stroke around the ice. They make it important.
They're not eligible for the Olympic Games, by the way. She is only 14 years old. In fact, she'll turn 14 next week. And Johnny is 15 years old. You have to be 15 by the previous July. The rule that was put in place last season.
They have a very youthful energy.
Tiffany, I think, has a quality that is so naturally animated. She reminds me of a young Katia Gordieva.
It's hard to believe from the length of her legs that she's only 4'10" tall.
Which is what Tara Lipinski is listed at.
There's an even more turned out foot for you, Peggy.
Yes, that's very nicely done.
Good performance. Very solid performance. They're very young. They need a long way to go before they will be ready for the World and Olympic Championships. But let me tell you, I think that they're really just a fine young pair.
Their father, John, and Stephanie, their sister, part of this crowd cheering them on. They brought this crowd out of their seats.
Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler, pair for the future. Back in Philadelphia, Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler, the brother-sister team. She is only 13, about to turn 14, and he is 15 years old.
And look at these side-by-side double axles. Now watch him in particular. That's where the trouble has been. Hers tight and clean, his fine. After falling three times in practice, it's nice to see him do it when it counts.
Required element marks 4.3. up to 5.2. That's a wide range.
Yes, it is. Somebody obviously thought there was some wide deductions to be made there.
Well, smiles all around them. I think they were thrilled with what they did on the ice. Presentation marks a wide range there, too.
And that's Irina Rodnina on the left and Elena Cherkaskaya on the right. Both of them worked with them.
Taking the ice for the first time at the senior level. At these championships, Katie Barnhart and Charles Bernard. They were the silver medalists from the junior nationals in 97.
Dotson Bowser and Jim Bowser work with this young couple. Editha Dotson was one of the early ice dancers with the John Curry Ice Dance Company.
Oh, that's too bad. She almost had that.
She had very nice spring. Very good position on his part. And not so good.
Skaters that train in Detroit or at Lake Arrowhead these days. Katie and Charles are from Alabama and they train in Huntsville. They stayed there to train and they won the Midwestern sectionals to get here.
Well, they're a beautiful, beautiful pair. Their line is first rate.
They're very willowy and real delicate out there.
Really, I mean, you know, that was a first-rate performance. The effect, the artistry in the line certainly showed a much greater history to that pair than the little time that they've had together.
Yes.
And their first trip to the Senior National Championships, they worked their way up through the junior level, 95 through 97, and won a silver medal last season. But their first foray into the seniors, and a nice start.
Now, on these side-by-side double axles, look at the back, the straightness, the line. She just doesn't have the right kind of revolution in the air to make it work. And it's unfortunate because the pair overall had a very nice quality. Oh, these marks just not strong enough. Four threes to four six and four eight, I think, to pull them up into any kind of a contention for that third spot.
4.8, 4.5, 4.6.
And the fall early on certainly cost them in terms of the required element marks.
Well, I think the fact that they're a very young pair in the sense that they've been together a relatively short period of time.
Now, she's 16 years old, he's 24, but you're right, they haven't been together that long, and this is their first trip to the seniors. The presentation marks 4.7 up to 5.2.
5.0 and 4.8.
Really seems like there are a lot of them in this competition, because I guess there are. Another young couple that's created a lot of excitement, Natalie Vlandis and Jared Guzman.
The music, Paso Doble, and the Pogo Pogo.
And this program is all about attitude, and watch how Jared understands that. And watch the exit of this lift coming up. He uses one arm right here to set her back down on the ice. Shows a lot of strength and control.
Also, the entrance to that lift was absolutely delightful, the way he just swept her into the air. And both of them missed those side-by-side triple loops. Now, that's going to hurt them very, very much.
Seemed like they never even got into those.
Neither of them did.
Well, it's a very difficult triple for them to be trying. Probably the most difficult triple that any of the competitors are doing in this competition. Very risky move.
Good circular steps. See, there's flair and excitement to this couple. And a lot of that comes straight away from his mother, the former U.S. pro champion, Jenny Walsh Kutzman.
And this choreography is absolutely stunning by Ponomarenko and Klimova, the Russian dance Olympic champions. Very effective work.
Double twist. He takes it very seriously. Really wonderful.
He's only 16 years old, and she's only 15. Natalie Vlandis and Jared Guzman, they won a junior national title in 96. Back with their marks in a moment. We're back in Philadelphia, out of breath. Natalie Vlandis and Jared Guzman, along with one of their coaches, Peter Gordon. Their marks coming in a moment.
And here is that lift, very difficult takeoff. Shows the strength and control on this landing. Watch this one arm that he sets her down. That's incredible strength.
Very nice. And this was less fortunate. Triple loops, both of them just opened right up and went nowhere. And of course, that'll be a disaster for their marks.
Especially in the first set. Required element marks. The range stick 4.5 up to 5.1.
They're rather consistent marks.
4.9. By the way, you mentioned Jenny Guzman, Jared's mother, one of their coaches. Unfortunately, she's away with bronchitis.
But she had the same flair in her skating years ago that he has in his. You can see that nice quality.
And now the presentation marks, and they are higher, 5.0 to 5.4. This is a pair, though, do you watch the 2002 Olympic Games?
And 5.4.
That's good. man.
So the standings are set after this short program, but this championship a long way from being over. What a battle it will be between Indian Dungeon and Mino and Sand for the title. Lions and Wells in third place and in a good position to capture the bronze medal. A number of young couples behind them. Right now, Leslie Visser is standing by with the leaders and defending champs. Leslie?
Well, Terry, 3 weeks ago, they went back to their old program, and obviously that was the right decision. Kyoko, why does this program suit you better?
Well, we had great success with it last year, and we just went out and wanted to do all the technical, and it worked for us.
Yeah, it was very dynamic. Jason, can you talk a little bit about you beat Jenny and Todd on a night when they skated very well, a clean performance. What does that mean to you?
I think for Kyoko and I, it's a great ego boost. It's been a very healthy rivalry, not only for Kyoko and I, but I think for Jenny and Todd and for American pair skating. But when it comes down to it, you know, it just boosts our ego a lot.
Well, it was so far so good. Congratulations so far. Back to you, Terry.
All right, Leslie, we'll see if they can defend their title Saturday night. Catch it on ABC. And make sure you're with us tomorrow night at 8 p.m.